Oh, is it happening again?
I mean, Azir is so good with Senna. Like, it's actually so good. And now that it has a tank variant, you don't just have to, you know, play back and play defensively.
That's Pyke.
Yeah. I mean, Draven seems to be the best option here. Ash is available. Ziggs I thought about, but because, you know, it has insane wave clear, and you can use the satchel in combination with a really good hook, so Pyke hooks, and then you satchel somebody back, and then you do a ton of damage to them, you stun them. There's a lot of combos you can pull off there. And it does scale pretty well, obviously, in terms of the burn damage you can put off with Karma plus Ziggs. Yeah, this continues to be a problem.
Or a solution, as Pleta is making it look more on the problem side of things. Nice satchel there from Teddy as well to keep him in close range.
Thinks still, they have the threats for the Senna. Pleta's roaming.
Yeah. Speaking of threats, Shifting Sands not actually going to be pushed, as still gets hit. But
he's going to make a second attempt here onto Canyon now.
Yeah, Sponge actually can be able to slow him down.
Yeah, I mean, this Twisted Fate lane is also going very well for Keen, right? Rascal's not going to get solo killed like I said up here, but can get some advantages. Ooh. He's going to Ghost.
Yeah, he's looking for it as Pleta's making his way in. Pleta is everywhere right now. Let's see where the Keen is going to... Oh, yes, of course.
Many of our East teams just think... meanwhile, a little bit of
a little bit of a kerfuffle, as there is the Destiny. Gold card already locked here for Keen, but slightly out of range of Sponge. Does not have the Ghost, as we saw it used earlier on the top side of the map. So not going to be able to punish there with the first Destiny. And now, another Bone Skewer gets the flash out from Keen.
Could potentially just try to look to take the Hens out.
Yeah, if they meant it, well, he does do a fair bit of damage.
I'm going to be totally honest, I think everybody knew this from the start. Okay, hold up.
Yeah, let's see where the trophy's going to... Yes, he just goes over the wall.
I was going to say, I'm going to be honest, Atlas, I didn't really think DRX could pull this off, but they are pulling this off. The macro has been good, the rotations have been good. Longest first blood, by the way. Passed now after 1330. But, I mean, this turret lives because of the Ziggs ult, and they actually might turn this into something.
Yeah, they're looking for Keen now, not able to get the stun, and he gets healed by Paze as well. The gold card comes in, Dawning Shadow down as well, and Rascal's not quite able to get it done. Pleta now running for the hills, but Chovy's going to catch up to him. Oh no! Sponge delivered, but the tower is still shooting. This is dangerous, but obviously not dangerous enough, especially when your Nautilus is as tanky as this.
But two turrets might go down for this. They bought a ton of time. They didn't turn into winning plays, and I think they definitely overextended up there.
Interview that he did do, and it did not, like, it didn't sound like any good news at all for DRX. This is a much better look, as Lahens going to get hooked and is going to get snared up as well by the Karma. Does have to flash.
It is very difficult to actually come in here and try to take this one away. Chovy doesn't have teleport.
Yeah, Canyon now looking for an option here, and he's just going to turn it. Pleta definitely is one of those. Does have a decent shield, but Canyon's going to close the gap. Picks up the kill onto the Pyke now, as that's a lot of damage. In goes Sponge. He finds the kick, but Canyon turns it. He's got the shield from the passive, and that's 4-0 now for Gen G. Satap grabs one back, though, onto Keen as DRX. They're sticking to it, but Lahens is so incredibly tanky, and I don't even think Cassante can do enough Cassante things to help this one. Even the Rift Herald gets amongst it as the Emperor's Divide lands onto Teddy. He's a bit of a monster, but not enough. Canyon goes down because he was battling a turret here, and the Sand Soldiers getting very aggressive. Somehow Pleta, he's back here once again. The Dawning Shadow flash was very cute there from Paze, and they take down the turret as well. Pleta gets out with the help of the Blast Cone.
And they are going to pull away. Chovy in the back of the pit now as Sponge just trying to take aggro off. Chovy already taking a lot of damage. The Malignant's Q does come through there as Keen throws out the gold card onto Rascal, who absorbs it. Oh, Dredgeline just barely missing as the Bone Skewer, that's going to land. And another Q, this one going wide from Satap. And Mantra going to be up very, very soon, though, as Teddy's waddling down. And this Drake, this one's going to be important. Soul Point is big as the Mega Inferno Bomb goes down. The Drake is secured by Lahens.
Down, back away, use some of that poke as Lahens.
Well, if at first you don't succeed, let's try again. As Undertow going to pull him back. Nice little, at this point in time. Yes, they have a scaling Ziggs, but the Karma is not going to get better, especially against this center composition with the Destiny Gate, as, oh dear, Teddy's dead.
Yeah, speaking of Destiny Gate, and win and start stacking them up as oh boy.
Yep, there's a hook. Death Charge going to come down as well, and there is no Sponge for this fight. I have a feeling that this is just... Baron has been up and available for about 3 minutes' time, and I think Gen G, they might even go over there as... All right, Satap's just really dead.
Well, they're just going to do Baron now because Satap isn't here, and Teddy, I mean, he's got ult, but even with these two items, he just doesn't do enough alone.
All right, how much is it going to take to kill Lehens? Do they even kill Lehens? As the Baron is going down as well, who's going to die first, Lehens or the Baron? It'll be the Baron, and Lehens then dies immediately afterwards. I'm not going to be able to find anything there.
This was not the right time to do so.
No. As Canyon is going to get spotted, but just does so much damage to Bledder as Rascal also in trouble. Chovy and his Sand Soldiers are just obliterating this Cassante. I have seen tankier looking Cassantes, I'm not going to lie to you, as now Paze is ganking. This is pretty cathartic.
Along with your champions, you don't want to be the ball.
Well, max range hook is going to connect there as Sponge once again going to go down. Lehens also probably going to go down as he decides that he'll accept the outcome as Keen is just destroying structures as TF absolutely loves to do. This inhibitor turret going to go down as well as Chovy looks for the angle. Gold card flies in as Satap just blows up.
Down. And as you mentioned, Rascal's not even that tanky, so even he's not gonna last.
Chovy flashes in, he finds the Emperor's Divide on two. More explosions as these cinders erupt onto the rift, and Cassante also gonna go down. Somehow it's Chovy that gets that kill, and then limps away with 100 health. And I think that the health bars are low enough for DRX to have at least one more defense option. Steal it with a Mega Inferno Bomb, who knows? Kickback does come on through there as Keen looks to try and get out. It's not gonna work, but it's also not gonna work for Sponge, so it's a one-for-one trade. Chovy also just splitting as these Nexus turrets in trouble, and Satap, that's one auto attack from a Sand Soldier.
If Chovy voted no, he said the Elder's not gonna spawn.
That's all I'm thinking, as Sponge, oh no, he is gonna get snared, will survive for the moment, as Lehens, a brick wall, as another kick does come down. It's Paze that's the target, All Out is going to be executed, and Paze just gonna flash away, manages to in fact get the kill onto the Cassante, and I think that that really does spell how this game is going for DRX, as Chovy is tanking Mega Inferno Bombs and will eventually explode into 1,000 cinders. The Nexus should do the same thing though, as Keen, he gets to be in the picture. The Destiny Gate does come through, and now he just gets to stand and play bodyguard as this Nexus will be taken down. Gen G, I mean, I think it was a really good attempt from DRX, but Gen G, just too good in the end.
Yeah.